Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We are so grateful and thankful to be in the house of God one more time. Let's give God some thanks and praise for waking us up this morning and starting us on our way and helping us get to the church house with a little bit of health and strength on today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We want to take the time just to say thank you to our CUCC friends. That is our cluster community. We had a wonderful 3 days of revival last week. We are so grateful and thankful for anybody that came into the church building or watched online and supported whatever way that you could. We're so grateful and thankful for your presence and for your participation. At this time, we are excited to hear what God has to say through our young people as they usher in the presence of Almighty God. So I turn it over to the anointed, to the appointed praise team. I turn it over to my sister who is leading us in worship this morning. Won't you give God a hand clap of praise for Brittany and for all of the praise team this morning. And so let us begin to prepare our hearts and minds to give God thanks and praise for all that he has done for us.
Amen. If you would stand to your feet. Welcome everybody and welcome those who are joining us online. We welcome you to worship up with us this morning.
I put it all in his hands. Let us prepare our hearts and our minds to go to the throne of grace with thanksgiving and praise. Father God, we come before you with humbled hearts, just giving you all the praise and all the glory. You are Lord, you are our Lord and Savior. Father God, you are El Shaddai, Lord God Almighty. You are Jehovah Jireh, our provider. You are Jehovah Rapha, our healer. You are Jehovah Nisi, our banner. You are the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You are the great I am. You are the God that created the heaven and the earth and everything within it. Father God, you are Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, and the bright and morning star, and the lily of the valley. And we love you, and we glorify you, and we magnify your holy name. Father God, we thank you for your son, Jesus, who went to Calvary and died for our salvation. And we are so grateful that he is seated on the right hand of the Father, interceding for us right now. And we just thank you, Father. Father, we ask that you forgive us for all sins that we've committed, known and unknown. Forgive us for all unrighteousness, Father. Father God, we pray for the earthquake and flood victims and all of the thousands of lost lives. Father God, we ask that you go to those regions right now, Father, with your holy and anointing presence, Father. Father, we just ask that you place a hand on them, on their families. Just give them some type of hope, Heavenly Father. Father, we know that you are omnipotent. You can do all things, Father, and we ask that you hear our prayers. Father God, we intercede for the sick and the shut in. Father, you know what they're ailing and what's going on in their bodies, their trials and tribulations. Father, we know that the prayer of faith shall save the sick and the Lord shall raise them up. And we know that you are true to your word, Father. And your word says that by your stripes they are healed. And we just stand on that word, Heavenly Father. Father, we ask that you touch the elders right now, Father. Father, strengthen their bodies and their minds. Father, put your loving arms around them. Send people around them, Father, just to love on them a little bit. Father, we also pray for the ones that have lost loved ones that are grieving right now. We just ask that you give them some type of hope and comfort right now, Father. Father, we also come to you just praying for our church and all the churches, Father. We ask that your holy and anointing presence fall down on our church right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask for the great outpouring of the Holy Spirit, Father, and that chains be broke, people be delivered, and people be healed in your name, Father. Father God, right now we pray for our pastor, Dr. Torrey. We ask that you continue to anoint her with your holy and anointing presence, Father. We ask that you fall fresh on her right now. We ask that you give her a fresh word for your people and that that word fall on fertile ground so that they may be able to be delivered, set free, and chains be broken, Father. Father, we ask that you continue to put a hedge of protection around her to protect her from all hurt and harm. Father, we just thank you. And we praise you right now in the precious name of Jesus. And our soul says amen. Amen. Amen.
Been touched, changed, healed, totally free from sin, every shackle broke. Now I can live again. Say, I have been touched, changed, healed. again. Say, I have been touched.
I have been touched.
Yes.
Changed.
Healed.
Totally
free.
From sin.
Every
shackle.
Because of you.
Because of you.
I've been restored.
I've been restored.
I've been renewed.
I've been renewed.
I've come alive.
I've come alive.
All because of you.
Because of you.
Say, I have been set free.
I have been set free.
By your love.
By your love.
set free.
Hallelujah, church. You want to just take a moment just to thank God for God. You know, thank you, God. All right, y'all. I don't want to interrupt. I just got a few announcements for you this morning. Then I'm going to go sit down. All right. So many of us may have known or heard that the passing of Mr. Stanley Offer. And so they are still trying to confirm the arrangements and details, but just continue to lift them, their family up in prayer as they mourn during this time, okay? All right. Now, as we've concluded the homegoing celebrations for Miss Helen Jennings, call her Grandma, the Jennings family extends our most heartfelt gratitude and appreciation for the Asbury Town Neck family. How you guys have shown was truly the hands and feet of God. And I say that personally as being a recipient of some of that love and just seeing it, you know, secondhand as well through some of my other family members. But thank you from the bottom of my heart. It allowed us to send Grandma home the way in which she should have went home, you know. So we really appreciate what you've done. You've sent more cakes and food than my grandpa can take in. More visits that we can take in, and I just appreciate that love. It's like a piece of grandma that you were able to give to us. So I really appreciate that for me, and then for also as a representative of the Jennings family as well. So thank y'all. All right, I'm sorry.
Okay, so I just want to give one quick announcement. She's not here, but I'm sure she's watching. On Thursday, I got a video. And so I'm going to make some noise, and I invite you to make some noise with me. I don't know if you know Latoya Williams. Y'all know Latoya, amen? So on Thursday, Latoya sent me a video of her ringing the cancer bell. So I just want to take some time. And we're going to just celebrate God that she was able to ring that bell, y'all, that she is cancer-free, Jesus. We are so grateful and thankful for a healing God, for a redeeming God, for a God who answers prayers up in this camp. We worship God this morning for his goodness and his mercy towards us, towards her, towards her family. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! So that praise, that shout is for Latoya, for Billy, for our mama, for our friends, for the nurses, for the doctors, for the saints, for those in this place and outside of this place who called on the name of Jesus for her. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. All right, so at this time, I do want to invite Marquan Lowe to give an announcement regarding events for our young people. Amen.
Good morning, church family.
Good morning.
It's been a while. So it's the time of year again. Trunk or Treat is about a month and a half away, and we're about to start our planning and everything. So next week, I will be having a planning meeting. Anyone who is interested in volunteering, I'm going to probably come ask some of y'all anyway. But we'll be having a meeting directly at the church. Just to get some logistical things together, as well as anyone who also wants to volunteer their cars to come, because we need lots and lots of cars. Please come out, just so I can get a head count and know exactly what we're working with. Also, we will have a game day. This is a youth game day. It will be October 15th. It's going to be for ages 10 to 16, or 10 to 18. Bring any youth that you all know that are interested in coming out, just to come fellowship. Just so they can actually see that they have a safe space here at the church. The church is for them. We want them here. We want you to come out and just fellowship with your fellow peers and the Lord. And we're going to just have games, some food, and just let them have fun. So there'll be more up about that in the church email within this week. And if anyone wants to help out or volunteer, just come reach out to me. Okay? God bless. Thank you all.
All right, y'all, just a few more. All right, so our church council meeting is going to be scheduled, is scheduled for Tuesday, September 19th at 7 p.m. It is on Zoom. The purpose of this gathering is to go over the reports and fulfill the voting criteria for our annual church conference. All Asbury Town Neck members are welcome. I repeat that. All Asbury Town Neck members are welcome to participate. We strongly urge officers, ministry leaders, lay servants, and lay servant candidates to be present. The Zoom link has already been dispatched via email. Additionally, a reminder will be sent on the day of the meeting. All right, and please make a note of our confirmed annual church conference slated for Saturday, October 14th at 1 p.m. The conference will be held in person at Eastport United Methodist Church in Annapolis. Any questions regarding the council meeting, please reach out to Brother Carol Hicks, our chairman. All right, and so starting this week, we're restarting the GPS, that's Grow, Pray, and Study Bible Study session on Wednesday, September 20th at 7 p.m. using Zoom. Minister Carla Fleming will be leading the discussion. This invitation is open to all. If you're interested in joining, please see the email for the church email with the Zoom link where the Zoom link will be had. All right, GPS Bible study. All right, and seniors, please remember to complete the interest survey available in the lobby on the table or in your email. Your input is highly valuable in planning enjoyable on-site and off-site activities. Submit the surveys to Minister Trudy Groves or the church office. And last but not least, please remember on Wednesday mornings, we gather together for our midweek prayer. Thomas Buxton says, "You know the value of prayer? It is precious beyond all price. Never, never neglect it." So we invite you to join us at 8 a.m. every Wednesday for a short devotion and prayer. The conference call number is in your weekly email and our church website. All right, and please continue to review the church email to stay abreast of what's happening. At this time, we prepare for offering, and there will be set our baskets that flow from the center and on the ends of the aisles as well. Thank you.
Greetings, Asbury Town Neck family and friends. Welcome to the ATN Network. Luke chapter 6, verse 38 reads, "Give, and it will be given to you, a good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use it, it will be measured to you. Therefore know, God takes whatever we give and multiplies it so that we can be blessed to be a blessing." Brothers and sisters, currently we have four ways to give. You can call 410-647-3461 to arrange an in-person drop-off. You can mail your tithes and your offerings to 429 Asbury Drive, Severna Park, Maryland, 21146. Or you can visit our website, asburytownneck.org, and click the donate button. Or you can use the Cash App at $ATNUMC. Thank you for your continual support of the ministries of Asbury Townack United Methodist Church. We invite you to continue to join us for worship and the Word.
Real quick. Father God, we thank you for being a giving God, Lord. We thank you for your love, your constant love, Father. Lord, as we have this opportunity to give back to you, Lord, we just ask that we do so in a cheerful heart, Father God, knowing that we are giving to you and your kingdom, Father God. You are faithful to provide that love back to us, Father God. So, Lord, we thank you so much for the opportunity to give back to you, Lord. It's in the precious name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Please stand. Please remain standing. Don't sit down. Time for the scripture.
Good morning, church. This morning, our gospel comes from Matthew 18, 21 through 35. Then Peter came to Jesus and asked, "Lord, how many times shall I forgive my brother or sister who sins against me? Up to seven times?" Jesus answered, "I tell you, not seven times, but 77 times. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants. As he began the settlement, a man who owed him 10,000 bags of gold was brought to him. Since he was not able to pay, the master ordered that he and his wife and his children and all that he had be sold to repay the debt. At this, the servant fell on his knees before him. 'Be patient with me,' he begged, 'and I will pay back everything.' The servant's master took pity on him, canceled the debt, and let him go. But when the servant went out, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 silver coins. He grabbed him and began to choke him. 'Pay back what you owe me,' he demanded. his fellow servant fell to his knees and begged him, "Be patient with me, and I will pay it back." But he refused. Instead, he went off and had the man thrown into prison until he could repay the debt. When the other servants saw what had happened, they were outraged and went and told their master everything that had happened. Then the master called in the servant. "You wicked servant," he said. "I canceled all that debt of yours because you begged me to. Shouldn't you have had mercy on your fellow servant just as I had on you?" In anger, his master handed him over to the jailers to be tortured until he should pay back all he owed. This is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive your brothers or sisters from your heart. Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. I don't know about y'all, but I certainly feel the spirit in here this morning. And God is really raining blessings upon this church, and it's beautiful to see. Amen. I welcome you to just call his name, speak to him how you want to speak to him. This is your time to worship. But he can't afford worse off than you. Be grateful. There's always somebody else who wants to be in your shoes. Be grateful.
Be grateful.
He always comes right in on time and makes you provide. He said, be grateful. Tell them one more time. Say, be.
Be. Oh, grateful.
One more time, just like that.
Be. Grateful. For it will be.
It will be. Grateful that you're here this morning. Be grateful that you woke up in your right mind. Be grateful that you have family sitting in the pews. Be grateful. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be grateful. Be grateful for all that God has done for you. Be grateful for his grace and his mercy that abounds in our lives. Let us be grateful because we serve an awesome God. We serve a good God. We serve a God who sits high and looks low and remembers us. We serve a God who does not punish us all the time for the foolishness that we have done. We serve a God that even when we sinned, he didn't kill us but redeemed us anyhow. And so we are so grateful. We are so grateful for the love and grace and mercy that we get to operate in because we serve a gracious God. Will you pray with me this morning? Will you pray with me this morning? Gracious and eternal God, I thank you. I thank you for waking us up this morning. I thank you for clothing us in enough of our right mind that we either turned on Facebook or YouTube or we got into our car or we walked across the street to come to God's house just to say thank you. Thank you for keeping us, oh God. Thank you for waking us up, God. Thank you for allowing us just to worship in community, be it virtual or in person, God. God, we thank you for all that you have done for us, all the healing power that you bestowed on us, all the restorative power that you have placed on the inside of us, oh God. God, we thank you this morning that you didn't leave us in the midst of our mess, but God, you delivered us. So, Lord God, this morning, I just ask that you would be with me. God, I ask that you will just hide me behind your cross, oh God, and allow the Galilean preacher named Jesus to show up instead of me.
Have your way, Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, Son, and Spirit, we pray. Let the people of God say amen. 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 I just ask that you pray with me and for me this morning. So in the documentary series, Live to 100, The Secret of Blue Zones, travel author Dan Butner explores five unique communities where the people live a very long and extraordinary lives. In one of his opening interviews, he asks a woman who was 101 years old in Okinawa, Japan, what is the secret to long life? She said to have fun. I thought that was kind of sweet, you know? Because I think sometimes we, as the people of God, we worship God, we come to church, we do this and do that, but I think we also have to make some time for some fun. And then she talks about not getting angry, essentially not sweating the small stuff. Sometimes we get so caught up in the minutia of life that things just get on our nerves and we find ourselves angry as things that we could just let roll off. I don't know about you, but I kind of fall in that category every now and then. And then she said to forgive quickly. That kind of stayed with me. As we enter into this text this morning, I think about this 101-year-old woman who says part of living a long life is learning how to forgive. Can we just go there this morning? Learning how, living a long life requires us to let some things go. Now, I got a few letters, so every now and then I like to bring in a couple big words. I try to bring in big words sparingly. I use the big words and I use some 10-cent words to explain the big words. But today we're gonna do just a real quick study and some Greek. I know y'all, but stay with me. I promise you, if you work with me, you'll see how it all comes together. So the two words in Greek for forgiveness is aphemi and charismai. Aphemi means to let go, to dismiss, to pardon, to give up, to let go of a debt. Let me say that again. Aphemi means to let go, to dismiss, to pardon, to give up, and let go of a debt. Y'all with me? That's the first definition for forgiveness. So keep that in your mind. Now, charisma means to do something pleasant and to show ourselves gracious. Wait a minute, hold up. So forgiveness doesn't just mean to let go, to dismiss, to pardon, to let go of a debt, but it also means to do something pleasant to show ourselves as gracious. Hold on to that. Keep those two definitions. We're going to come back to that. All right. So when we enter into our text on today, this is a text all around forgiveness. And so Jesus begins having this conversation. It's a follow-up to what he is talking about in the previous couple of verses in Matthew chapter 18. So stay with me. And so when in Matthew chapter 18, Jesus tells us in order for us to be the greatest in the kingdom of God, we must approach God like children. We can't be the cause of somebody else's stumbling or downfall, that God will rejoice over one soul that's lost, that's coming back to him. And he even tells us how to deal with offense in the community. He says, I just want to give this little brief thing just in case you missed it. It says, if you got a problem, don't go and call everybody and their mama to talk about the problem. It actually says go to the person. That's what the word says. And if you can't come to an agreement with that person, then you call two or three witnesses to come alongside of you to serve as mediators in the midst of that thing so that you all can work that out and continue in Christian fellowship and community and not let things linger. I just need to park right there before we get into the rest of Matthew 18 But before we could get there, we got to learn how to forgive and what's the structure of forgiveness and how do we work out some things when we just don't get along sometimes. It requires us to go one to another and begin to have a conversation about how this didn't work out just right. And maybe, just maybe, if we just did that every now and then maybe some of the confusion would stop. Amen? Amen. So let's go on back to Matthew real quick. Let's go on back to the rest of Matthew chapter 18. But if I could just do a little parenthetical explanation of Matthew, if you will. Is that all right? Matthew is known as the teaching gospel. So Mark is kind of the apocalyptic gospel. That's the signs and wonders gospel. You got Luke, who is the healing gospel, because Luke, the writer of Luke, is a physician. So all of his work is really about healing. And then when you get to John, that's the I am text. So if you want to know about the character of God, then you read the gospel of John. But when you are in the gospel of Matthew, this is about teaching how to become a part of the kingdom of God. Don't miss it. The kingdom of God is here and yet to come. And so Jesus is setting us up to learn how to participate in the reign of God, in the work of God, right now and yet to come. Y'all with me? And so the way that Jesus does that is that he teaches parables. Y'all know what a parable is. It's a simple story used to illustrate a moral or spiritual lesson. And so when we get to this part in Matthew 18, when Peter says to him, Lord, how many times shall I forgive my brother or sister who sins against me? He says up to 7 times. I just want to remind us that Matthew gives about 23 different parables to talk about how to work out problems and circumstances. And so when we get to this part, it's not unusual for Jesus to use this illustration to teach a moral lesson so that they would be able to get it and take it beyond this conversation, so that over 2,000 years later, we're still looking at the same parable and trying to get the same lesson in which God was trying to get Peter to learn all the way back then. Y'all with me? So, you know, he says, well, how many times should I forgive? How many times should I let go? How many times should I dismiss? How many times should I just move out the way and let you have your way? How many times, Jesus, do you think up to 7 times? Because I think 7 is a good number. 7 is the number of completion. So maybe it's up to 7 times I can let some things slide. Well, Jesus answered, I tell you, not 7 times, but the one version of the scripture says 77 times. But if you want to get into the different translations, it actually says 70 times 7. Don't miss that. It's actually 70 times 7. He's trying to tell them there is an infinite number of how many times you should forgive. And he's doing this not just because, oh, it sounds good and it might make us feel good if we know that we're supposed to forgive and let go. And he tries to break it down this way. He says, therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants. And as he began the settlement, a man who owed him 10,000 bags of gold. The scripture, depending on your text, says 10,000 talents. Can I break down what a talent is, if that's all right with y'all this morning? One talent equals 6,000 denarii. That was the money back then, right? And an average worker earns 1 denarii per day. So this guy was in a lot of debt, y'all. If you only get 1 denarii per day, you done did something that you got $10,000, 10,000 denarii worth of debt that you got to work off. I don't know about you, but that's 10,000 days. That's a long time to have to work off this type of debt. And the scripture says, since he was not able to pay this debt, the master ordered that he, his wife, and his kids, they all had to be be sold into slavery in order to pay the debt. Let me break this down to you. If you had debt back in the day, they could capture you, your wife, and your kids and put you all into slavery together. And you as a collective got to work off the debt. So who knows if it's going to take 10,000 days or what have you for the whole family to be free. But guess what? We love God and we love the scripture. The scripture tells us that on the seventh year, on the year of Jubilee, that all the slaves had to go what? Free. But that it means that they at least had, 10 years. No, they at least had 6 years of debt to work off to family. They at least had 6 years of having to be subject to somebody else's rule and way of life. They had 6 years of being in an uncomfortable circumstance before the seventh year when they could be free. But the servant did something. He said, you know, please be patient with me. He got down on his knees. He started begging to the master, please be patient with me. Please, I promise I'll pay everything back. Please have mercy on me. Please don't take me and my wife and my kids away from one another. Please don't let us have to be in servitude. And the servant took pity on this man and he canceled the debt. Remember what I told you, what forgiveness was. Forgiveness was to let go, to dismiss, to pardon, to give up, to let go of the debt, and to do something pleasant to show oneself as what? Gracious. Don't miss it. So in this moment, we're seeing what it means for what forgiveness looks like. It's not just that the debt, it means that the debt was paid and forgiven, meaning that you don't got to do anything else. Because of my word, because of God's word on our lives, y'all, the debt of our sins have been paid. Can I say that again? Because of Jesus Christ, because Jesus died on the cross for us, the debt of our sins, because remember, the wages of sin is death, and the gift of God is eternal life. And because we call on the name of Jesus, our debt, our sin has been paid. But sometimes, y'all, we don't want to offer the same grace, the same forgiveness that has been offered to us. Well, Dr. Tori, what do you mean? Let's go on back to the text. We can find out right here, right now. But when that servant had a similar situation and he found one of his fellow servants who owed him, I'm just going to say $20. Amen? He owed him $20. The scripture actually says he owed him about 100 silver coins. What he did was just totally unthinkable. He grabs him by his neck and he begins to choke him and says, pay back what you owe me. Did he not just experience the grace and mercy of the master? Didn't he just not experience what happens when your debt is forgiven? He forgot what had happened was in his own life. He forgot that somebody was looking out for him. And when somebody begins to look out for us, the greatest payment we can do is extend that to somebody else. And so he just forgot who he was. He forgot the grace of God that was hovering over him. And so when the man refused, he went off, had a man thrown into prison until he could pay the debt. Now, didn't he just get saved? Didn't his family just get saved? And then when the master heard what had happened, the master called him and said, you are wicked, man. Can I make it plain? You have lost your mind. Are you crazy? Didn't we just have a good conversation? Didn't I just wipe this stuff off of you? Wasn't I just gracious and merciful to you? Didn't I show you what forgiveness looked like? And weren't you supposed to walk that out for somebody else? And since you don't know how to act, since you don't know what to do, I'm going to put you back in the jail. And not only am I going to put you back in the jail, I'm going to make sure they torture you until you are able to pay back what you owe. Whoa. The scripture says, this is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive your brother or sister from your heart. Let's just go there for a second. Right, it is harsh, right? But it puts some things in perspective for us. If God forgives us 70 times 7 and God continues to let go of our sins, our mistakes, he doesn't hold anything against us. He actually casts our sins in the sea of forgetfulness. Brothers and sisters, God is calling us to learn how to forgive one another, to learn how to let go of some stuff. Because if we don't let go of some stuff, we're going to be in a season and situation of torment. And God is not going to make things comfortable for us. We're going to be disturbed in our sleep, y'all. We're not going to have patience for nobody. We're not going to know how to talk to nobody. Every word that we have is going to be filled with anger and disappointment and distress. People are going to know that something is wrong with us. So if we don't learn how to let go, how to dismiss some things, how to pardon some things, how to let some stuff roll off our back and off our shoulder, we're not going to be able to offer the grace and mercy that was offered to us to somebody else. Can we just get real this morning? Unforgiveness blocks blessings, y'all. It blocks some stuff. When we don't have an attitude of gratitude, like that woman who was 101 years old, she talked about enjoying life and not holding on to anger, y'all, and forgiving somebody. That will get us long life. I personally believe when we hold in stuff, when we hold in unforgiveness, guess what? We start having breathing problems. We got stomach aches. We got back aches. We got stuff that begins to appear in our bodies because we are holding stuff in places and spaces that literally make us physically uncomfortable. But when we are walking with God, when we understand that we serve a God who paid it all for us, who has bought us with a price, who has loved us in spite of us, we have learned how to offer that same love and grace to somebody else so that when the time comes, we can talk about a loving and forgiving God who said, I have covered it all. And because I have covered it all, I'm going to offer that same type of forgiveness and covering to somebody else because I know what it meant to me. Because we need to make it personal, y'all. How many of you know that God is a forgiving God? How many of you know that God didn't kill you for your foolishness? How many of you know that God saved you in spite of you? And so God is inviting us to let go, to dismiss, to pardon. And can I get real? Sometimes, can we just get a little bit in our personal business sometimes? Sometimes somebody asked us for a couple hundred dollars and we are still hung up on that couple hundred dollars. It might be $50, it might be $20. If they had it to give you, they would have given it. They wouldn't have had to borrow it from you. Can we just go there? If they had it to give you, they wouldn't have had to borrow it from you. If you don't have it to give, then don't give it. Can I say that? If you don't have it to give, don't give it.
Because then all of a sudden now we got strain in our relationships when we could just give it, let it be a blessing, and move on. Because now you're so frustrated, and now you're trying to figure out, how can I really forgive them for not paying back XYZ amount of money? Where Jesus said, wait a minute, we need to be figuring out how to forgive the debt. I know I'm just making it practical, making it real on today. Is that all right? Because sometimes we just got to be real about this. How do we apply to this? This is one way that we can apply it. If we don't have it to give, don't give. But if you do have it to give, give it and let it be a blessing and move on. All right, I'm going back to this real quick. I'm going to close it up. It says, this is how my Heavenly Father will treat each of us unless you forgive your brothers or sisters from your heart. Don't miss this. We also understand for some folk, forgiveness is a process. Sometimes some forgiveness don't happen like the microwave minute and everything is fine and everything is over. Sometimes it continues to require some conversation. It continues to require, it's a choice every day that you wake up that you're going to forgive what happened to you yesterday, what happened to you 5 years ago, what happened to you when you were 5 years old. Sometimes it takes a conscious effort, not just to forgive others, but also to forgive yourself. Can I say that before we move on and close off in prayer? It's important for us to learn how to forgive us. Remember that torment I was talking about? That's a torment that we can face on our own, that nobody has to inflict on us. But some things that we have done, that there is some shame and some blame attached, and God does not want us to carry that, because to forgive means to let go, to dismiss, to pardon, and to do something pleasant and show ourselves as gracious. Don't you think that you deserve the grace of God? That's God's unmerited favor. If we want to get into prevenient grace, that's God's all-encompassing love for you. That's the love of God that goes before you. Before you even knew God, that's the love of God that was already existing, already moving, already dismissing your sins. So I just came by to tell you on today that God is asking us, will we let go? Will we dismiss some stuff? Will we pardon some stuff? Will we let go of the debt on somebody else's life? Will we just say, Jesus paid it all, so I don't have to continue to worry about this mess anymore? Will we show ourselves as gracious, not just to other people, but to us? Because the same God who is blessing us, the same God who is forgiving other people's sins, is the same God who is loving us and keeping us in our right minds, and who offers us grace and mercy all the days of our lives. Brothers and sisters, on today, do you know that Jesus paid it all for you? That sin has lost its crimson stain, that he has washed us as white as snow. Do you know that on today? Do you know that on today, that Jesus has paid it all for you? I pray on today that somebody who does not know Jesus and the pardon of their sins, if you would like to know him on today, the altar is open. Would you come at this time? If you would like to rededicate your life to Jesus Christ, and maybe you were going left and it's time to go right, the altar's open. Would you come at this time? We would love to pray with you and for you. If you would like special prayers on this morning, maybe there's some things you need to let go of, some things you need to dismiss from your spirit, from your heart, some people you might need to be reconnected to, and maybe, just maybe, you might need to forgive yourself on today. The altar is open. Would you come? 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Miss Mary, would you go down for me? Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. We give God thanks and praise for this day, for all that he has done for us, for all the ways that he has made, all the ways that he has forgiven us of our sins and cleansed us from all unrighteousness, for all the ways that he has moved in our lives. We give God thanks and praise. God, we thank you that you have forgiven our debt. There is a newer version of Jesus paid it all and says, oh, praise the one who forgave our debt and gave this life and raised us from the dead. And so, God, I thank you that you continue to raise us up, God, that you continue to raise us up so that we don't have to live in our sin, that we don't have to know that crimson stain, so that we might know somebody who washes us whiter than snow, God, that we might know somebody who enters in the midst of our chaos and brings peace and brings life and brings abundance, God. God, on today, we ask that you would come and just breathe new life onto us, God. God, we ask that you would come and just remind us that we are not alone, Jesus, that you come and remind us, God, that you are moving some things out the way, Jesus. God, we thank you that in the midst of our trial and our tribulation, oh God, you show us that there is another side, God. God, we thank you on today that you know how to make the wounded whole, God. God, we thank you on today that you know how to breathe new life onto us, God. God, we thank you on today that you are a healer, God. God, we thank you on today that you are a comforter, God. God, we thank you on today that you are our guide, God. God, we thank you on today that you breathe new life into us, God. God, we thank you on today that you forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness, God. God, we thank you on today that the same forgiving power that's in you is also in us, God. God, help us to extend the grace that we have received on Calvary, God. Help us to extend the grace that you have given all of us on this side of heaven, God. God, in the name of Jesus, we just come this morning saying thank you for your grace and mercy. Thank you for healing, God. Thank you for protecting, God. Thank you for walking with us and talking with us, God. Thank you for reminding us, oh God, that we are not alone, Jesus, that you are indeed with us, that you have not forsaken us, that you have not failed us, oh God. God, we worship you for your goodness and your mercy. God, I ask in the name of Jesus that you will continue to breathe new life on each and every one of us. That you will show us your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. We want to remind everybody that the altar continues to remain open. There might be some folk who just still need to be here for a little bit. And we just want to continue to let them pray and worship. And if you feel like you still need some time after church, the altar will remain open. We invite everyone to stand on your feet at this time if you're able. Hallelujah. Will you stand on your feet if you're able? Will you raise one hand or two hands unto God at this time? Gracious and eternal God, you are a faithful God. You are a loving God. You are a sustaining God. God, you are a forgiving God. And God, we ask that we might forgive as you have forgiven us. God, that we would pardon the sins of others as you have pardoned our sins, God. God, that you would speak life over us, oh God, as we continue to speak life over others, Lord. Lord, we just pray on today that we might offer the same grace of God to others as you have given to us. God, remind us that you paid it all on Calvary so that we might all have abundant life. So God, help us to live into that abundance today and forevermore. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, we pray that the people of God say amen, amen, and amen. We love you, family. There's nothing you can do about it. Go and make today a great one.
But we get up, we fall down, but we get up, oh yes. For a saint is just a sinner who